Alrighty, I would like to play first. Alright, this is a keepable hand. It's much better on the play because I don't have to discard to the bounce land on turn 2. And it's a fine hand. Turn 1 Forest, turn 2 Boros Garrison, turn 3 Nissa for a Plains here and can cast all my spells. It's not spectacular. I would love to draw. Like, if I drew a Signet or a Talisman and I got turn 2 Talisman, turn 3 Nissa bounce land, turn 4 Sigarda, turn 5 Yosai, that would be awesome. My opponent also mulliganed to 5, so there is that. But my curve here, I almost played Boros Garrison turn 1. That would not have turned out well. The curve here of Sigarda, Yosai, Atarka is pretty nice. Arashi, the Sky Asunder is not really what I'm looking for, but I suppose I'll take it. Let's see. Opponent has a Manic Salarant? Yes, they do. Marble, Diamond. Just straight up. Taps for a white. It's a Plains that comes into play tapped. Ooh, Kanama's Reach. That's much better than Nissa. Alright, so I'm going to get a Plains. And I guess I should just get an Island. Put a Plains into play. I have double green. Now I have double white. I already have red for Atarka, so I just get an Island, and then later I can get Swamp, and I can just cast Thraxamundar. Black-white. Is my opponent only two colors? That'd be impressive. I've drafted the Legendary Cube a couple times, and ended up in five colors every time. Alright, well, let's draft, or let's smash with Sigarda. Basically, there's nothing my opponent can play in a turn to kill this, because it can't get edicted or targeted, so opponent has to now untap in Wrath, but it'll at least take their turn to do that. Saizan, Perverter of Truth. It's not a bad card. Each player loses 2 life and draws 2 cards every turn, so makes the games kind of crazy. Land, slamming Yosai the Morning Star. Tarka can finish off a Saizan at some point later, but slamming Yosai is pretty awesome because if my opponent kills it, then I get to tap down their board, and if they attack with Saizan, I'll probably just block and the same thing happens. Or I could not. I could just smash for 10 in the air and then play a Tarka. It's also pretty good. So what do I do? Probably just take the 6 here. Go down to 12, then I go to 10 off the ability. Obviously, I miss out on, or I lose extra life if my opponent attacks, then post combat has a sweeper, but I think that might be alright. Oh, opponent just chose to straight up Wrath. Alright. Well, my opponent gets to take a turn off here because of Yosai's ability. Tap all those down, and they do not untap during my opponent's next untap. And they didn't play a land. They drew a bunch of cards off Saizan and did not play a land. All right, so I have 6 mana, 7 mana when I play Island. If I play Talisman, it's 6. I want to Elodomri's Call for Maelstrom Wanderer. So I want to make sure I can cast Elodomri's Call, and I want to cast... I guess what I can do is I can cast Talisman and then Harmonize. I guess I have to play my land first, so I can leave Elodomri's Call mana up. And I have to discard now? I'm just going to discard Crow's Converge. It's my only land, but I have Nissa if I really need to hit a land drop, and I don't really want to discard Luan, because who knows what my opponent's playing. And then, let's get... Maelstrom Wanderer, and then next turn I'm playing Maelstrom Wanderer, who needs another land. Alright. Well, let's cascade into some action, shall we? Talisman of Unity, we did it. And... Nissa's Revelation, alright, well, we did do it. Scry 5, so let's put bottom, bottom, top, top. 16 cards left? Yeah, I can draw 6 cards. Draw 6 cards off leaving Thraxamundar on top. Maelstrom Wanderer comes into play. I left a Swamp on top just to make sure I could cast Thraxamundar. I guess I even have the Talisman here, but whatever. Land. Smash my opponent. Ooh, my opponent has... What costs 1 black? Oh, Vendetta? Alright, my opponent lost some life there, and it's fine. Land. Cultivate. Boros Signet, it's probably fine to discard. Nah, just discard another land. Could maybe discard Nissa instead, but nah, Nissa seems fine. So I have 2, 4, 7, 11 mana, so I can play multiple things next turn. I'm not going to get decked. I have 11 cards left in my deck, and if my opponent taps out for a giant monster, I can probably get it. Yeah, that's not going to do a whole lot. So let's go Thrax and Mundar. And attack my opponent with Thrax and Mundar. Ooh, does my opponent have Swords to Plowshares? They do not. Thrax and Mundar, funnily enough, will stay the same size because it was getting +1 from Ascendant Evankar, and then gets +1 because something got sacrificed. Opponent goes to 1, and let's just cast Pelucranus. Yes, this sets me up for a sweeper, but I have 4 more threats in my hand, so it seems fine to do that. No plays, huh? Alright. Time to send. See if my opponent has an answer. They do! Oh, Devouring Shadow. Alright, they killed Thrax Mundar and paid 7 life. So, playing against black-white, that makes me want Lawan a little less. And I guess All Sun's Dawn is probably a fine replacement. Yeah, not like thrilled about that. I could just put in the Rafik just to have a creature to play earlier. Alright, what do you got? Rafik is good in this hand. I think Rafik makes this hand keepable. Between going second, scrying with Temple, I've got a decent shot of finding one of my accelerants, and Rafik is a turn 4 play if that all fails. Alright, Kadama's Reach, not bad. Put Sigarda on top because I have Kadama's Reach, so I can reach into Sigarda. I'm going to take a little bit of damage off Kaithion. Kaithion does not seem very good in this cube. There's just not that many cheap creatures, unless my opponent's drafted some kind of black-white beatdown deck. Probably going to have a 2-drop into a 3-drop and prove me wrong, but I don't know, at least that's my impression. And go. No reason to expose Savannah to land destruction, if that's even a thing. Hit down to 16. Does my opponent have a creature? No. Alright, let's cast Kadama's Reach. So I've got all the mana for Sigarda and Rafik, so I should just get Mountain Swamp. So I can play Thrax and Mundar. I don't have double green now. I've intentionally made it so I don't have double green, but given that I've got good plays the next couple turns, I figure I can find my green sources. There's a Maelstrom Wanderer, if you don't say. All right. Sigarda is still an excellent play. It's just so hard to get rid of Sigarda. She just is just one of the best threats, I feel like. And next turn, I can play Rafik and slam for 12 in the air. I might just end the game. I'll hit for 12 with Sigarda, and the turn after that, threatening another 12. If my opponent does something, then I get to play Thrax and Mundar. If they like sweep the board or something, I go Thrax Mundar, hit you for 6. And then the turn after that, I get to play Maelstrom Wanderer. See, I don't have double green, so I am forced to not leave Illidomri's Call up here. Rafik and Smash. Alright, does my opponent have like... No, it can't even be sacrificing, attacking, or blocking creature. Oh, my opponent Vendetta's Rafik now. Ooh, that's going to be ugly. Unfortunately for them, that means they fall down to 5 here instead of going to 12. They took 7 damage off that, which conveniently enough makes Sigarda lethal. So, looks like that's where we're heading next turn. Let's see if my opponent has an answer to that. Wrath of God, yeah. Wrath does kind of stop it, except I get to play Thrax and Mundar. My opponent now has to have an instant speed removal or just die to Thrax and Mundar, and if they do, just play Maelstrom Wanderer next turn, and that's probably going to be good enough. Ooh, they do have instant speed removal. I actually don't mind that. Yeah, I'll put a counter on Thrax and Mundar, sure. Because I kind of want to cast Maelstrom Wanderer. Maelstrom Wanderer is a very fun card to cast. Man, Devour Flesh was also getting stopped by Sigarda. Sigarda is a house. Day of Destiny. Legendary creatures you control get +2/+2. Sadly, it doesn't matter what I hit with Maelstrom Wanderer here since everything's lethal. I hope I at least get to see, though. Dragon Lord Atarka, nice. So I was hitting for 15 and get to cast Nissa's Revelation, even nicer. So Maelstrom Wanderer, cast the maximum possible amount of mana worth of spells, given that I got to play 2 7 drops off my cast 8 drop Cascade card. And I got to Surok Dragonclaw it up and attack for millions. I guess that's what the Legendary Cube's all about, so there we go.